and welcome to another episode of This, That, and the Other. You remember the drink 7-Up, popular drink, similar to Sprite. Well, 7-Up is probably not as popular as Sprite is now. It still is on the market, but I don't see it as much or hear as much advertising for it. My dad told me years ago that 7-Up used to contain lithium, and I found that it was created in 1929 and contained a lithium mood stabilizing drug. Charles Leeper Grigg from Price's Branch, Missouri, moved to St. Louis when he was 22 years old and started in advertising sales for soft drink companies. He invented his first soft drink called Whistle while he was working for a manufacturing company owned by Vess Jones. I remember Vess Soda in the St. Louis area. I don't remember Whistle Soda. Conflict with management, he left the company, found a job with a new soft drink manufacturer when he invented another orange-flavored drink called Howdy. I actually saw Howdy bottles in Okinawa. And it looks like the one on this picture, it says Howdy, and on the other side it's being Japanese. I didn't realize that was an American company. Went on to form the Howdy Company together with financier Edmund G. Ridgway and lawyer Frank Gladney. At the time, Orange Crush dominated the market for orange sodas, so he decided to focus on lemon-lime flavors and came up with the formula for a lemon-lime soft drink in 1929. Spent 2 years testing with many different formulas, Grigg invented a new drink called Bib Label Lithiated Lemon-Lime Sodas. Wow, quite a long name. It hit stores 2 weeks before the 1929 stock market crash. There were around 600 other lemon-lime sodas, but the new drink actually sold pretty well. The Bib Label Lithiated Lemon-Lime Sodas contained the compound lithium citrate, mood-stabilizing drug used in various patent medicines at the time. Grigg claimed that the lithium ingredient in the soda could affect the drinker's moods. Lithium citrate was used for decades for psychiatric treatment of manic states and bipolar disorder as a supposed cure for hangovers at the time as well. In a column published in the New York Times, Cornell University professor Anna Fells wrote, "Lithium drinks were in huge demand for their reputed health-giving properties, so much that the element was added to commercial drinks. 7-Up was originally called Bib, Lithiated Lemon-Lime Soda, and contained lithium citrate right up until 1950. In fact, it's been suggested that 7 and 7-Up refers to the atomic mass of lithium. Maybe the 7-Up referred to mood." Kind of interesting story on that. So it had lithium up to 1950. Oh, another thing, the government banned the use of lithium citrate drinks and soft drinks in 1948 and was removed from 7-Up. So I guess in 1948, Grigg died in 1940, and his son took over the company. So that's what I was able to find out on about 7-Up having lithium in it. I really know lithium could be put in something that you put in your mouth, but I guess take some turkey internally, but I guess you can. I've heard lithium, I think lithium could, in relation to cars, to engines, or something like that. It's kind of stuff used for that, I believe. And I could be wrong on that one, but I'm running out of ideas right now on what to do, what subjects to discuss. Like I said, I do history. It's about preserving history, and a lot of times obscure aspects of history like this one, and any of you listeners, I'm getting more and more subscribers as the days go, and which is great. I'd like to have some suggestions from my subscribers on what I could do subjects on, and I can definitely research it. And in most cases, I can come up with something in relation to the subject, and base a YouTube show on it. As always, like, subscribe, share. Thanks for watching. Thank you. I didn't realize I still had this on, but cool song, isn't it? Until next time.